stand up for Jesus. Ye soldiers of the cross, lift high his royal banner. It must not suffer loss. From victory unto victory, his army shall
Jesus, as we start our children's story, I pray that we'll understand it. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Hello, boys and girls. We are amazed with the never-ending love for God for us and for you. That's why we say God is good
all the time.
And all the time.
God is good, and that is his nature. We, the teens class, are happy to be preaching the children's sermon this month. Last week, Brenda, Michael, and Cynthia taught us lessons about the wonderful gifts given to us by God and how the disciples used them in organizing the first church. They even gave us an example from the Bible about the church and how it is like the body. Do you guys remember that?
Of course. The biggest lesson they taught us is that all gifts are important and everyone can use their gifts to make the church of God a wonderful place for everyone.
You know, I do recall them saying that when we use our gift to serve God, we may land into trouble here and there. Because, of course, Satan is never happy when we serve our Heavenly Father.
Yup, but hold that thought right there. This month, we're learning about fast. This means the first things that happen. For example, last week we learnt about the first church, and today we will tell you about the first Christian martyr.
Our theme still is the period of fasts. Look, he said, I see heavens open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God.
Guys, shall we talk about seals?
You mean that big thing from the sea? Why talk about a sea mammal?
I knew somebody would say that. Zola, that's why I gave you the letter. And the letter contains some secret confidential message. That means a specific person can read it.
Oh dear, sea animals on envelopes now? This is interesting.
Open and read what is inside.
Boys and girls, listen carefully. In the book of Revelation, we are told of a time when John saw Jesus opening a seal. Inside the seal was an altar, and under the altar, he saw souls of dash.
Yo, that was beginning to get really interesting. Who are the people who are seen under the altar?
All right, guys. I'll tell you, only if you pay attention. He saw souls that had been killed because they had promised to serve their Lord, and also because they went to the highways and the byways, which was more dangerous to do so. Guess what? As they were given white robes to wear, they waited for God to revenge on their death. And I'm so sure that Stephen was among those people.
Stephen? You mean the Stephen we learnt about last Sabbath, the head deacon?
This is really beginning to make a lot of sense. You know why? Because Stephen was the first Christian martyr. The Bible really is interesting, isn't it? Can you tell the children of this awesome, amazing, and wonderful first Christian martyr?
Yes, of course, children. Stephen was a godly deacon who promised to serve the Lord. He was also courageous because he took every chance that he had to tell the people the true word of God.
The teachers and doctors always debated with him, thinking that they would win the debate. But to their rude shock, they couldn't resist his wisdom and the good spirit that was always in him.
I can tell he was clearly a good student of Sabbath school, adventurers, glorious chorale, and master guide.
The more Stephen preached, the more they insulted him. Instead of listening to him, they planned of ways of getting rid of him through death.
Until one day, they caught him and took him to the Sanhedrin, who, children, as we have learned from our previous sermons, were the judges of the Jews.
At the courthouse, many lawyers and religious people came to accuse Stephen.
Whoa. Ladies and gentlemen, is that who I think it is?
My goodness, that, my dear friends, is Saul of Tarsus. I have heard of him. He's a very learned and well-spoken man, but he's also a very dangerous guy. I think he is the lead attorney.
Lead attorney? What's that?
That means he is representing all the accusers of Stephen. For example, Jesus qualifies as our lead attorney in heaven.
And children, with Saul as their lead attorney, they went forward and accused Stephen of preaching false and dangerous teachings.
But boys and girls, Stephen was cool and calm. His calm wisdom meant that the priests and his accusers could not find anything against him. He was truly innocent. But they were so determined to make an example of him.
The priests and the rulers hired false people against him. Children, bearing false witness against someone is commandment number what?
That would be commandment number 9.
That's correct. Children, they accused Stephen of blasphemy. Do you remember when Jesus was accused of blasphemy? Jesus had told the people that he was the Son of God and he was equal with God. He also told them that he will destroy the temple and build it in just 3 days.
So children, the priests and the rulers did not believe Jesus was the Son of God. And so they went through the court and told them that it was not correct.
Oh, poor Stephen. As he stood there, his face was shining with holy light. Children, did you know that the people who were there trembled and covered their faces because the face of Stephen was like that of an angel?
Can you imagine that even with all that, they still did not believe Stephen?
So now, boys and girls, there were movements in the room. The people became angrier. The priest and the rulers, pretending to be more angrier, stood up and tore his clothes. But Stephen resisted and asked them, "Why do you guys resist the Holy Spirit?" With courage and power, they did the same to Stephen.
And with that, they rushed to Stephen and caught him. It was like the priest had become cruel wild animals.
My goodness. What happened next was that Stephen was taken to the council and he prayed and was offered to the court.
To him, the gates of heaven opened wide. "Behold, I see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of God," said Stephen.
And with that, they took him away from the city and one by one began to throw stones at him.
Kneeling down, Stephen prayed, "Lord, lay not my sins against them."
That sounds really familiar. When Jesus was about to die, he too said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." And he died. Both Stephen and Jesus forgave their accusers when they died.
Children, to serve God is a wonderful honor. To walk with him is a great joy. To be saved by him is to be saved forever. And to die with him is to live with him.
People that there were amazed by the love Stephen had for Jesus. Guess one person who? The lead attorney, Saul of Tarsus. As Saul continued to persecute Christians, he met Christ and became a zealous servant of God.
Boys and girls, the story of Stephen teaches us so many lessons. First, Stephen was a kind and compassionate man who used his talent to take care of others. We too, boys and girls, can help others as we are guided at church and taught by our parents at home. Christine, tell us what else can we learn from this story?
Children, Stephen was a faithful servant. We too can be great Bible students as we continue to study the Word of God and do all things including Christ. Diana, a final lesson for us.
A final lesson for us is that one day you and I, boys and girls, will be called to be martyrs for God. And when that day comes, we should stand up like Stephen and embrace the cross of Christ. And until the trumpets sound, we will proudly stand and boldly say,
stand up for Jesus, that trumpet call. Obey, for to the mighty conflict in this his glorious day, ye that are in now serve him against unnumbered foes, let courage rise with danger and strength to strength oppose.
Let's pray. Our kind and loving Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the story that we've heard. And I pray that, God, one day we may be martyrs for you, just like Stephen. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Children, thank you for joining us this Sabbath. Join us next Sabbath as we study about
the gospel in Samaria.
But for now, bye.